Hey guys, Jordan with the Young Turks, TYT Politics. Happy Friday, coming to you live from my kitchen as per usual. And for those of you complaining about the kitchen, reinforcements are on the way. I might be getting some signage for the Young Turks sent to my home, so I will have a little bit more of a professional look soon enough. But you know what? It's the content of the message. It's not whether I'm coming to you from my kitchen or the basement. So be happy I'm alive, well, and coming to you. I hope everybody's doing well. I wanted to ask you something first before I get into the topic. So I've seen some comments requesting shorter videos. Maybe you don't have enough time to watch a 20-minute video. Some of our video are 30 minutes. So you tell me, do you guys want shorter videos, a little bit more to the point, less information, kind of more quick to the point, digestible, or do you like the video structure as is, where every video kind of has different length, and some of them are longer, some of them are shorter. I'm here to service you. Emma's here to service you. We don't want to make videos that are too long where you don't have time to watch them. So you guys tell me. You could leave comments in the comments here, as well as on YouTube once we make this video into a YouTube video. Shorter videos or you like the length of the videos now. Now, I have two topics today. I'm going to start actually with the Republicans. I am going to say something to you guys that you're probably not going to like, but I got to keep it real. Okay? So throughout the Democratic primary, unlike most of the media, did not cover Trump to the length of 24/7. I did not cover every tweet. I did not cover every booger. I think that that's a disservice to the American public. Do I think that Trump proposes a unique threat? I do. But I also felt that by covering him 24/7, you were letting another corrupt person off the hook. So I let the rest of the media cover him 24/7 because I didn't feel I was adding any value to report to you for the 100th time what you're seeing online and on TV. But I do think Donald Trump's a dangerous threat. I didn't vote for Hillary Clinton. I voted for Jill Stein. But the gentleman I want to talk about is John Bolton, who is right now under consideration to be Trump's Deputy Secretary of State, right under ExxonMobil CEO Rex Tillerson. Now, Rex Tillerson is going to have a nomination fight on his hands. I believe he'll get nominated. But John Bolton, if he's going to be deputy, most of you probably don't know, but the deputy under the Secretary of State is really the person who hires out a staff in the State Department. So this would be John Bolton. I believe, based on evidence and years of knowledge, and I used to work at Fox News, I talked to John Bolton a few times. I think John Bolton is a unique threat to the country. I think this goes beyond political corruption. You're not going to like what I'm about to say, but I'm going to be honest with you. If it was John Bolton as the Republican nominee against Hillary Clinton, I would have not only voted for Hillary Clinton, I would have knocked on doors for Hillary Clinton. I would have bit my tongue. I would have vomited in my mouth and tried to get her elected because I think John Bolton is such a unique and dangerous individual that I think if he gets anywhere near decision-making power, if he gets anywhere near hiring other staffers, this is a real threat. This isn't the fear-mongering. This isn't the fear-mongering that you see from the mainstream media 24/7. There are some questionable cats around Trump, but John Bolton is a lunatic. He's a lunatic. This is beyond just Trump derangement system. John Bolton, if it was up to John Bolton, we would have World War III followed by World War IV. There's not a country he doesn't want to go to war. He basically makes John McCain look like a peace dove. This is how scary this guy is. So if you're not familiar with John Bolton, I'm going to read you a little information so you know why he is dangerous. John Bolton, he worked in the Bush administration. I don't remember his position, but he worked in the Bush administration. He's been on Fox News for years. There's been rumors that he was going to run for president. Scary, scary guy. So I'm reading to you from reason.com. Reason.com is actually a libertarian outlet. I read them sometimes. They're pretty good. I'm certainly not a libertarian, but libertarians tend to agree with progressives on a lot more than corporate Democrats do. So I'm going to read you some of the craziest things he has said, craziest policies, and just so you know, this is a grave, grave concern that progressives, corporate Democrats, anybody need to come together. I don't care if Hillary Clinton people, if I have to join in with Hillary Clinton supporters and corporate Democrats. This goes beyond political corruption. Political corruption is the least of our issues if this guy gets close to power. Okay? So, number one, Bolton was a primary cheerleader of the war in Iraq and stands for everything Americans rejected about the Bush administration's foreign policy. To this day, John Bolton says it was right to go into Iraq. He wouldn't change a thing. Even Republicans like John McCain, Lindsey Graham, have backtracked a little bit and voiced concerns and said, you know, we weren't exactly right in everything we did. The most neocon, hawkish Republicans have called Iraq a mistake. This is somebody who says, no, it was great. So, quote, we are confident that Saddam Hussein has hidden weapons of mass destruction and production facilities in Iraq, Bolton said in 2002, while serving as President George W. Bush's Undersecretary of State for Arms Control and International Security. That wasn't true, as we'd later discover. Hindsight is 2020, but not for Bolton. In 2015, he told the Washington Examiner he still thinks the Iraq War was worth it and claimed, quote, the worst decision made after that was the 2011 decision to withdraw U.S. and coalition forces. In Bolton's mind, U.S. troops should have occupied Iraq in perpetuity. By the way, George W. Bush negotiated us getting out of Iraq before he left office. So Obama gets the credit or blame, whatever side you're on, but it was George W. Bush who negotiated that. Reason continues. I've given up expecting much consistency from Donald Trump, but it's still a little surprising that the Donald would be considering Bolton for a high-ranking place in his administration. After all, Trump's initial rise in the Republican primaries was largely due to his brilliant takedown of Jeb Bush, which hinged on reminding everyone why putting another Bush in the White House would be a bad idea. So, obviously, the war in Iraq is a big fat mistake, Trump concluded, before hammering Jeb for taking more than a week to answer reporters' questions about whether his older brother made a mistake. Now Trump wants someone who has taken 13 years and counting to do the same. So, again, Iraq being a mistake is kind of a bipartisan agreement at this point. You won't find that many leading Republicans who say unequivocally, no regrets, Iraq was great. But John Bolton thinks it was a great thing. He thinks we should still be there. And if John Bolton gets anywhere near the Secretary of State, remember, Secretary of States work with the Secretary of Defense. So if John Bolton is the Deputy Secretary of State, he will be working with Mad Dog Mattis, who's Trump has nominated to Defense Secretary. And that's another scary cat. The second thing, Bolton wanted the U.S. to go to war with Cuba over weapons of mass destruction that didn't exist. A year before the United States would go to war with Iraq due to falsely believing Saddam Hussein possessed weapons of mass destruction, Bolton was advocating that the United States go to war with Cuba because of later debunked reports that Fidel Castro was developing weapons of mass destruction. In May 2002, during a speech at the Heritage Foundation, Bolton said he believed Cuba was developing biological weapons and was capable of distributing them to Libya and Syria. The New York Times reported on the speech, "The United States believes that Cuba has at least a limited offensive biological warfare research and development effort," Mr. Bolton said, taking aim at the communist government of Fidel Castro. Cuba, he added, also provided dual-use biotechnology to other rogue states. The Times noted that it was the first time an American official openly accused Cuba of developing biological weapons. When the Times asked Bolton's office to substantiate the historic and potentially bellicose claim, they offered no evidence. Number three, Bolton really, really wants to bomb Iran. Having apparently learned nothing from the decade-plus quagmire that resulted from the invade now, come up with the exit strategy later, Bush administration approach to the Iraq War, Bolton in March 2015 advocated for a similar bomb now and figure out the details later approach in dealing with Iran. In a New York Times op-ed titled "To Stop Iran's Bomb, Bomb Iran," Bolton argued that, quote, only military action could accomplish what is required. The thing being required was preventing Iran from developing a nuclear bomb. A limited strike against known nuclear production facilities could set the country's nuclear ambition strike back 3 to 5 years, Bolton argued, and should be combined with, quote, vigorous American support for regime change in Tehran, because we all know about the successful track record of regime change in the Middle East. So this guy wants us trying to topple dictators in Iran, because it worked out so well in Iraq, it worked out so well in Libya, it would work out terrifically in Syria. We're talking about arming rebels in Syria. We don't even know half the time who the rebels are. Reminder, Osama bin Laden, many, many years ago, was considered a rebel against the Soviet Union. He was considered a rebel. And we all know what Osama bin Laden became. As reasons Matt Welch noted at the time, quote, one of Bolton's main stated concerns is that Iran's pursuit of nukes will and is already beginning to set off a regional nuclear arms race, which would indeed be alarming. But isn't there another possible game theory scenario here in which a preemptive attack on Iran, like the preemptive weapons of mass destruction justified attack in Iraq, could incentivize regional powers and various nefarious regimes to go nuclear faster? After all, the U.S. doesn't spend a lot of time engaging in forcible regime change with countries, no matter how lousy that already have the bomb. No matter how they already have the bomb. And Ukraine, for one, can tell you what happens to your defensive posture after emptying your nuclear arsenal. So not only is this guy crazy, but what he doesn't understand, if you go to, I'm not saying let Iran do whatever they want, but if you try to go to a war with Iran, Iran has nuclear capabilities. The Iran deal might have slowed them down, but they still have nuclear capabilities, and they have leaders crazy enough to use nukes. And Iran is also an ally of Syria and many other Middle Eastern countries that aren't exactly in love with the United States. This guy's a lunatic, okay? I think he's a legitimate target, Bolton said, according to the Daily Beast. Oh, excuse me, I went ahead. Number four, President Obama followed Bolton's terrible advice about Libya, and then Bolton blamed Obama for the resulting mess. In March 2011, while mulling a potential run for president, Bolton suggested to an Iowa crowd that the United States should try to assassinate Muammar Gaddafi, the then dictator of Libya. I think he's a legitimate target, Bolton said, according to the Daily Beast. He has murdered innocent American civilians. He has never faced responsibility for it. So I don't have any hesitation in saying that. Later during the speech, Bolton admitted that he was willing to let Gaddafi live. Quote, I personally would be happy to send him into an exile somewhere, is how he put it, according to the Daily Beast, but said it would probably be easier to just kill him and let someone else take control. All right, so we killed Gaddafi, and how did that turn out in Libya? This guy has been wrong on every single foreign policy idea, proposal, and action he's ever proposed. He's never been right. Number five, Bolton suggested Israel should unleash nuclear weapons against Iran. Perhaps the most terrifying manifestation of Bolton's desire to bomb Iran, no matter the costs or consequences for America, to say nothing of the consequences for the people of Iran fixed in the crosshairs, occurred in 2009 while Bolton was speaking at the University of Chicago. Unless Israel is prepared to use nuclear weapons against Iran's program, Iran will have nuclear weapons in the very near future, Bolton said. It's been 7 years and Iran hasn't developed a nuclear weapon, and Israel thankfully didn't follow Bolton's advice. So either Bolton was exaggerating the threat, or he doesn't have a good understanding of the words very near future. The logic here is almost too twisted to untangle. Bolton argued that Israel's preemptive use of nuclear weapons against an enemy, parentheses, an act that would smash all international norms regarding the use of nuclear weapons, should not only be considered, but should be encouraged. Such an action would not destabilize the region, parentheses, to say nothing of those smashed international norms, he seems to be arguing. Yet at the same time, he believes that Iranian efforts to develop a nuclear bomb, perhaps a defense against exactly that this sort of threat from Israel or the United States, are destabilizing? Trita Parsi, the then president of the National Iranian American Council, told Mother Jones that Bolton ought to ponder the aftermath of an Israeli nuclear assault on Iran. Quote, there is a day after you use a nuclear weapon, he said. If you want to maximize collateral damage and really make sure that the Iranian-Israeli conflict will be another unending Middle East conflict, then nuclear weapons is your path and John Bolton is your guy. Pondering the consequences of an unhinged, aggressive foreign policy isn't Bolton's strong suit. It's stunning that someone who has been so wrong so many times could end up running one of the most important parts of the U.S. government. Before the election, many people were questioning the wisdom, or lack thereof, of giving a temperamental, vindictive, and irresponsible man like Donald Trump control over America's nuclear arsenal. Those fears hopefully will never be realized, but letting John Bolton set the country's foreign policy does nothing to calm the nerves. So, you guys know me by now. You know I don't like to fearmonger. I don't like to exaggerate things. When I say, if this guy was running against Hillary Clinton, I would have voted for Hillary Clinton, I think you get across how dangerous of a threat I think this person is. Okay? Trump, he says a lot of crazy things. He's already walked back the Muslim ban. I guarantee you the 11 million undocumented immigrants are not being deported. Trump said what he had to say to get elected. I think he's going to govern a lot differently. It doesn't mean we don't have to be vigilant against him, but there is not a track record of Trump actually executing on the crazy things he says he's going to execute on. This guy, from the hallways of Fox News, from the studios of Fox News, to when he was with the George W. Bush administration, has actively taken part in every neocon, crazy extreme right policy. And the fact that Trump's even considering him scares me to death. And it should scare you. This goes beyond like, yes, we know the Republicans are bad, but focus on the corporate Democrats. I focus a lot on corporate Democrats, the Democratic establishment, the corruption. I'm going to be talking about Keith Ellison in just a few minutes, but we cannot take our eyes off dangerous. This guy's borderline sociopathic and frankly a fascist. And if he gets in office under Rex Tillerson, by the way, Rex Tillerson, there's no guarantee Rex Tillerson is going to be confirmed. He faces a very heated confirmation hearing. He got an award from Russia. We know about the Russia fear-mongering going on right now. So what happens if Rex Tillerson doesn't get confirmed? Maybe John Bolton moves up the ladder and is nominated for Secretary of State. This would be a disaster of epic proportions. So I'm telling you, take it very, very seriously. I hope you're sharing this on social media. I hope you share the video after when it goes on YouTube. I hope you are calling, if you're in a Republican area, calling your local politicians and flooding social media against this guy. Because this guy, if he is anywhere near the levers of power, he will help start World War III. That is not an exaggeration. Rashawn, you want to hear about my time at Fox News? I'll do another video on it for you. And by the way, just to repeat, the Deputy Secretary of State does a lot of the hiring. They do a lot of the hiring for the State Department. So if this guy is appointed Deputy Secretary of State, he will be bringing in other lunatics in the State Department. Tread lightly.